Quinnipiac began its season with much fanfare and lofty expectations. So far, the Bobcats have justified that hype as they've captured six of their first eight games. Today, Quinnipiac looks to continue its excellent play when it takes on the formidable Rhode Island Rams. It's a terrific test for the Bobcats, and the exam gets underway next. Live from the TD Bank Sports Center in Hamden, Connecticut, it's Quinnipiac University basketball. This afternoon, the Bobcats take on the Rams of Rhode Island University. And a very good afternoon, everybody. I'm Bill Schweitzer. My partner is Bill Mackett. Well, this is a very dangerous game for college basketball teams, for all of them, because starting on Monday, they're all going to be taking exams. How will the players fare in this game, Billy?
Well, I think it really matters that two players play well. You talk for Quinnipiac, Ruddy's their best player. He needs to play well. And James from URI. If your best players play well, you don't need to worry about exams, partner.
And when you talk about best players, you take a look at Quinnipiac, and it's like a weather report, Billy.
It sure is. You got thunder, and then you got lightning. And in Justin Ruddy, you have thunder. You got a guy who might be the best in the region who just pounds the offensive glass and coming off some real big games against the A-10 teams. 30 last year against URI, 27 the other night against UMass.
And he's a guy averaging a double-double. And then there's lightning.
Well, lightning is as good as it gets in the backcourt in James Johnson. 72 straight starts for Quinnipiac. Real strong with the basketball and has really developed that outside jumper. He's very important to this Quinnipiac team, their leading scorer.
There you see it, James Johnson averaging almost 19 points a game. And when you take a look at the Rams of Rhode Island, you cross over the border into Kingston, Rhode Island, it's the same weather report.
Well, yeah, when it rains, there's thunder and lightning there too. And you talk with Delroy James, silky smooth left-hander, averaging 21 points a game. He's been dominant, can put it on the floor, can shoot the three, clearly one of the top players in the Atlantic 10.
Averaging 22 points a game.
And then you got the backcourt kid, the Lightning with their team, the kid Jones, who's now averaging 11 points a game after five last year, 500 assists, fifth all-time at URI. He's off to a very good start.
Indeed he is. He's the one that makes the Rams go in the backcourt. And we're going to bring in the third member of our team. Now, when you talk about Quinnipiac, one of their big advantages is rebounding. They're very proud of that stat as we bring in Jamie Parker.
Thank you very much, Bill. And Billy, hello. Happy to be here with you guys this afternoon. As you know, Quinnipiac is one of the most dominating teams in the country when it comes to the boards. I spoke with Coach Moore before the game, and he said this is something that he's been preaching for the last 4 years that he's been here. And guess what? His players have been listening, because entering today's game, the Bobcats are fourth in the nation in both rebounding margin and rebounding average. And so far this year, they have out-rebounded every opponent that they faced.
And speaking of a rebounder and thunder and lightning, Maya Moore was here earlier for the women's game, one of her high school teammates playing for West Point. Stay right there. We got a big one coming your way on NESN. Quinnipiac and Rhode Island all even here in the early going of the first half. And Justin Ruddy, every time you talk to somebody, they call him a beast on the boards. Let's go to Jamie Parker for a little bit more on that. Jamie?
Thank you, Bill. Well, that's right. Justin Ruddy is in his final season.
Something I know that I always leave here at Quinnipiac. Like, it's my senior year last year. It's something I know that I've done. I accomplished something really well here at Quinnipiac, being as, I guess, the best rebounder at Division I level, but becoming all-time will be something even greater.
There he is, Justin Ruddy, and boy, he does it off of both boards. One of 16 players in the nation, averaging 15 points and 10 rebounds a game.
Well, if you're going to be famous, you need to do it on the offensive end, and Ruddy certainly has.
And there he goes, and there's his first basket of the afternoon on the drive to the hoop.
But the advantage he had.
Quinnipiac out in front by 5 here, almost midway through the first half. You know, the beginning of this season, Quinnipiac was wondering who's going to be the go-to guy at crunch time. But last Saturday here at the TD Bank Sports Center, James Johnson raised his hand and said, I'll take that job. Well, there you see a stunning win over Mount St. Mary's. He hits 2 3-point bombs, then makes the steal and the basket at the buzzer to win it by 2.
And you never thought you would see Clark Kent turn into Superman, because he usually goes in a phone booth. We watched it. James Johnson turned into Superman, 8 points in a real short period of time, and won that game for Quinnipiac, Willie.
All right, Bobcats with a 4-point lead as we've been watching. Jamie Jackson has the unenviable task of trying to stay with Delroy James of Rhode Island. But as we find out from Jamie Parker, Jamie Jackson's got some pretty good moves.
Yes, he does, Bill. As a matter of fact, I caught up with him before the game because he apparently is the dancer on the team. And he taught me it's called the mosquito dance. And let me just tell you, he tried to teach me. Notice I said tried. All right, here is the Jamie and Jamie show. I'm here with Jamie Jackson, who apparently is the dancer of the Quinnipiac men's basketball team. Now, Jamie, I know I've heard all kinds of that. You have some great moves. Can you show me a little bit?
Yeah, this it's a dance move called the skeet. Everybody on the team does it. We just get wild. We do it.
Head down the stretch to halftime.
Quinnipiac's been better.
This should be an interesting second half, Billy. You know, Rhode Island, very athletic, very long team. Tom Moore standing by with Jamie Parker. Let's send it over to them. Jamie?
Thanks, Bill. Yeah, close physical game first half.
Yeah, I think, their length and their size, their athleticism, something we don't see too often. You know, we saw it against UMass a week ago, but I think our guys are responding pretty good to that part of it. For the most part, I thought we executed pretty well offensively. We took about 4 bad shots down the stretch, though. I think we could have extended the lead if we had a little more poise.
We try to get ready into the game a little bit more of 4 points. I'm sure he's looking for more.
Yeah, he is. The rest of our guys, though, they're doing a good job at sagging on him. And what happens sometimes is, you know, he takes so much help side attention. It gives our other guys a lot of open looks. And the perimeter guys get a lot of good shots, I thought.
All right, good luck in the second half, Coach.
Thank you, Jamie.
All right, back to you, Billy and Bill.
All right, thanks, Jamie. The Bobcats with the 3-point lead. So we look at the move here and the basket by Jamie Jackson. The Bobcats by 3. To come into this fairly new building, the TD Bank Sports Center. Quinnipiac getting more and more high-powered teams to come in and visit them here. Let's get a little bit more on that. Jamie Parker is standing by with the athletic director, Jack McDonald. Jamie?
Thank you very much, Bill. Yeah, Jack, just talk about the level of competition that you have faced in this building so far.
Well, when the trustees first talked about Division I, they were wondering if we'd ever play schools like Harvard, Yale, Rhode Island, UMass, Ohio State. And I said, I hope so. Well, 10 years later, that's all come to fruition. And it's just amazing how much Quinnipiac is now in the sport and academic world. And now we're on television in NESN with a great bunch of crazy Bobcats.
We do have crazy fans. As the 2010 season comes to a close, what do you have in store for Quinnipiac as it comes to an end?
Really, we're coming to the end of a phenomenal decade. And we're looking forward to talking to all of our fans and students about what was the best sporting event at Quinnipiac the last decade. So I want all of our fans to look at our website, QuinnipiacBobcats.com, and fill out a survey so they can tell us what they think was the best sporting moment at Quinnipiac in the last decade. So we've got a great bunch of fans, as you can see, and it's only going to get better and better.
So we want these fans behind us to certainly get involved, but I want to know what you want to say to these great fans as the holidays get near.
I want to tell them to say thank you. And keep up the good work. Go Bobcats.
All right, Jim Barron of the Rhode Island Rams. Now, you know, it's always great because nobody of us gets to peek into the locker rooms. Tom Moore usually gives us the okay to go in. So let's take a little listen to what he had to say to his troops in the locker room at halftime.
First half with a lot of offensive confidence. Play the second half with as much offensive confidence. Guard, guard, guard. Make sure we're guarding, we're alert, we're staying in stance longer than them. Let them stand up off the ball. You make sure that we stay in stance off the ball longer than them. And remember, on our weak side drive, anytime they go head tap at the end and they're bringing it this direction, as they're bringing it this direction, this guy is our guy. Dave, one time it was you, and you got to be bigger. You just got to be bigger. They got to see the white jersey on this side as they start to look at him. All right, so get to that side of the court. Let them fire it back out. We'll close on the diagonal. All right? Come on, let's go. Come on, let's go.
All right, Bobcats with a five-point lead over Rhode Island here with just over 10 minutes to play. You know, a lot of excitement on this campus with basketball and hockey in this brand-new building, but there's another team that's had a lot of success at Quinnipiac, women's cross-country, and standing by with the coach Carolyn Martin, our Jamie Parker. Jamie.
Thank you very much, Bill. Yeah, coming off, you guys were just recognized on the court, coming off your sixth consecutive NEC championship. Can you sum up the season for us?
We have a very young team. We have a great group of girls. They're all academically very strong and athletically just awesome athletes. We were very excited to go into the season, and I'm just looking forward to another season with a really young team. I think we're going to continue to do even better and better.
This was your first season as the head coach. You were assistant coach. What was the toughest transition for you?
It's hard to say. I feel like the girls kind of knew that I was probably going to be hired. I think they were excited about having me as a head coach, but it definitely is a transition going from, you know, just the coaching part to now I have to be in charge of the whole program. And being in charge of everything is now a little bit tougher than I thought some things would be.
It seems like you had no problem maintaining the success, so congratulations.
Thank you very much. Appreciate it.
Back to you guys.
All right, Jamie with Carol.